The Sonic Heroes Essentials Mod Collection creates the definitive way to experience the game on PC. Some of the improvements featured here are true widescreen support, faster loading times, increased resolution, uncapped frame rate for two-player mode, and more. We are also going to install the Fix Compilation files that restore a bunch of features and bug fixing. This is the best way to play Sonic Heroes on PC, and this tutorial will cover how to do that. Okay, so the first program we're gonna get is 7-zip, because we're gonna have to extract a couple of files in this tutorial, but this is for Windows 10. If you are on Windows 11, you don't really need this, because Windows 11 can extract files natively. The link for this page will be on the description of this video, so you're gonna go ahead and click here to download the file, and you're going to put this on the desktop of your PC. Now, on your desktop, you have the file, and the installation is very straightforward. You just double-click on the file, this window will open, and all you have to do is just click on the install button, and there you go. We're done here, and you can go ahead and delete this file. We're not gonna need this anymore. Still here on the desktop, I have the folder with the files for Sonic Heroes inside. I'm gonna double-click that to show you. And these are the files for the PC version of this game. And you're gonna need the vanilla version without any mods installed, which should look just like the one that I have here with me. But because of YouTube's guidelines, I cannot show you here on the video where to go to get the game, because it's basically piracy, and if you do that, they will delete the video and strike the channel. So you're gonna have to sail the seven seas, you know? Google is your friend, that sort of thing. But it's not hard to find. Just make sure that it's the vanilla version of the game without any mods pre-installed, or the mobile version, something like that. It needs to be the vanilla version, which is going to look like this one. Now, to install the required mods for this, we're gonna need this tool right here called Reloaded 2. This is basically a mod manager. I'll put the link on the description of this video. And in here, you're gonna scroll down quite a bit, actually, there's a lot of information, until you arrive here on this section, Available Downloads. And right here, under Assets, the file you're gonna need is the first one that says release.zip. And I'm gonna go ahead and download this to the same folder where the game files are, just to keep things organized, but it can be anywhere on your PC. So go ahead and download this file. So now back on the Sonic Heroes folder, we have the release file, and this is where 7-zip is going to come in. On this release file, you're gonna click on it with the right button, put your mouse on top of 7-zip, and then you're gonna select this option, Extract to Release. That is because there is a bunch of files inside here. So using this option, we're gonna keep everything on a folder. So go ahead and click on this one. It shouldn't take long. And there you go. At this point, you can delete the original zip file. We're not gonna need this anymore. Now on this release folder, double click on it, and you're gonna see a bunch of files. But the one you're gonna need is right below here. Scroll down a little bit. Is this file here, Reloaded 2. And you just have to double click on this one to open. And when you double click on this, there is a good chance that it's going to tell you that you need a couple of programs in order for this to work. I'm putting them on the screen right now. So whatever it shows up for you, you're going to click on the download button of these files and install everything you're gonna need. When that's done and you open the manager, you're gonna see a screen like this one. It comes with a tutorial on how to use this whole thing, but for now, you're going to click on skip the tutorial, and you're gonna be left with this window right here. And the first thing we're gonna do here is add the game itself. And for that, you're going to click on this plus icon on the left. And if you followed what I did and your files for the game are on the desktop, the manager should open for you by default. If not, you have to navigate to where the files are here on this window. On the root folder of the game, the file you need to select is this one, tsonic_win. So go ahead and double click on this one. And as such, you're gonna see the name of the game here and some options for the mods. And from Reloaded 2 is where we're gonna grab all the mods we're gonna need for this game. And to start, click on the first icon here on the left where it says Download Mods, and just like that, it will list all the mods available here. And the first one we're gonna get is the Essentials Graphics Pack for the game. So right here, click on search mods and you're going to type essentials like this one. And right here on the top, it should appear for you the essentials graphics. This is the first mod we're gonna get. Make sure that it's made by this user right here. This is the correct one. So go ahead and click on this and it should take you to a window with information about the mod itself. But all you have to do is just click on this download button right here. And you just wait until the download is finished. And if you click here on the icon for Sonic Heroes, you're going to see that the mod is located right here. But by default, this is turned off. So the first thing you're gonna do is click on this little square right here, and it's going to switch to this plus icon covered in red. This means that the mod is activated for the next time you start the game. And this is where you can tweak the mod configuration by just clicking here on this configure mod button. So go ahead and click on that, and this window should open up for you. I'm going to maximize this so we can see everything. And on this first option here, you can see all the settings available for this mod. And a bunch of them are already enabled by default. And these ones are gonna be up to you. If you want to remove the subtitles for the game, or if you want to turn off the music or the sound effects, this is where you can change everything. But one option I want to show you is the resolution. And this one doesn't have the usual options drop down menu to switch the resolution like we are used to. We have to manually input the resolution you want to change here. And by default, this comes with the 720p resolution, that is 1280 by 720. And with this mod, you can crank up the resolution up to 4K. So I'm going to put on the screen right now the information about each resolution that we are used to. And depending on the monitor that you have, you can select the correct resolution here. In my case, I have a 1080p monitor. So in here for the first option, I'm gonna switch this one to 1920. And on high, this is going to be 1080. And also right here, the option for full screen is turned off. So go ahead and click on this one to enable. When you're done, don't forget to click on the save button here on the bottom. And just like that, the settings are done. Go ahead and click on close. It's going to take you back here. The second mod we're going to get is the widescreen revamp one. And this mod basically reworks the UI elements of the game so that it's displayed correctly now that we are playing on a widescreen resolution, right? So now here on search mods, you can just go ahead and type revamp. And this is the mod right here. This is the user that made it. Make sure that it's the right one. So go ahead and click on this. However, for this mod to work, first we're gonna need these mods right here, toner, universal file, and CRI. And you can grab all of these mods by just clicking on each one of them. It's going to open a web page for each one of them. And from there, we can download to the reloaded two. I'm gonna show you how it is. Click on the first one, toner, and it's going to take you to this page right here on Game Banana where the mod is. Now you just have to scroll down a little bit and arrive at the file section. And all you have to do is just click here where it says reloaded to one click install. When you click on that, this window will open, and then go ahead and click on open reloaded to. And you're gonna see this message here from reloaded to saying that the mod was downloaded and installed. And now you just have to do the same thing for the other two mods. Click on this one. For the file redirector mod, you're going to see that there's three options here, and the one you're gonna need is the one on the top. So just click on the button, open reloaded to, just wait until the mod is downloaded, click on OK. Now you just need the hook one, click on that. The page will open, scroll down, and there's only one file this time. Click on that, open, wait for the download to finish. There is a chance that this error message might show up for you, but don't worry, go ahead and click on OK. And just like that, the mod will be installed as well. So now that we got all these files, we are ready to download the actual revamp mod itself. So just click on the download button, wait for the download to finish. Now, if you click on the Sonic Heroes icon, you're going to see all the mods that we just grabbed. And like the first one, they are turned off. So go ahead and click on each one of them to activate. And there's a few settings on the widescreen revamp mod right here. You can basically change the HUD style if you want to show up the Xbox or the PS2 buttons, for example. This one is gonna be up to you. Pick the one you want to see and then hit the save button. You don't have to configure the other mods. Now, the last thing we're gonna need is the Fix Compilation Pack file. The link for this page will be on the description of the video. And in here, you can also see all the fixes that this mod can do. But either way, to get the mod, you're going to click on this Download File button and then just click on the Download option. Go ahead and put this on the folder where all the files are. Now, back on the folder, the file is a zip one. And if you have 7-zip, you can just double click on this file to open it like this. I'm doing it this way because we're gonna have to move the files in here. So on the 7-zip window, double click on the patch, and inside you're gonna have these two files. So what you're gonna do here is just move these files into the game folder. And you can do that by just pressing and hold the left button on your mouse, select both of these files, and now you're going to press and hold the left button again and just drag them into the folder. When you do this, it's going to ask you what you want to do. Click on the first option, replace the files in the destination. Now we have to patch this BPS file into the executable of the game. And you can do this online in this page. The link will be on the description as well. And this one is very straightforward. On the first option, run file, click on where it says no file chosen. And the first thing you're going to select is the game executable, that is the T-Sonic Win file, right? Go ahead and double click on this one. Now go back to the website. You're going to see the information here. Now on patch file, click again on no file chosen. And back on the game folder, you're going to select the BPS file. So double click on that. And we are ready to apply the patch. So go ahead and click on this button. Keep the name as it is right here, T-Sonic Patch It, and go ahead and click on the Save button. Now back on the game folder, you're going to see that we have the original file and the patched one. We are not going to need the original one anymore. In fact, we need to get this out of this folder. So this would be a good moment for you to make a backup of this file. In case something goes wrong and you have to come back to this part of the tutorial, it is a good idea to keep the original file. So you can just make a copy of this file and then just put it anywhere on your PC. But because I did this before, I'm just gonna go ahead and delete this file. So now, like I said, we have to rename this one. So what you're gonna do is just click on the file with the right button on your mouse and then pick the option here on the bottom, rename. And all you have to do is just click here on the end of the name. And you just have to rename the patched text from here so that it looks like the original file. And then press enter, and there you go. We already applied the fixes, and the game is ready to go. So now you're gonna go back to the mod manager, because this is where you're going to run the game every time you want to play this. You can, however, create a desktop shortcut so you don't have to come back here every time you want to play the game. You can just launch it from your desktop. You just have to click on this one and then hit OK. You can play this with a keyboard and a controller if you want. From what I looked up, the game has native support to Xbox and PlayStation 4 controllers. I'm not sure about third-party controllers or DualSense. And there is also a mod for custom mapping as well for your controller. So if you want to do that, go ahead and grab this mod. And now to start the game, you're going to click here on the launch application option. Wait a few seconds and then the game will start for you. Here on the main menu, the controller might not work for you, so you're going to use your keyboard, press the enter button. And from here, you can use your controller just fine, or the keyboard. And as such, you can start playing the game. I have many tutorial videos like this on the channel, so if you like what you saw, don't forget to check out my other stuff. Subscribe to the channel, leave a like on this video, and as always, I'll see you soon.